nombre del Señor Jesucristo en esta tarde.
We're going to be reading a scripture before we start.
Vamos a leer una escritura antes de comenzar.
It's found in Psalms 18.
Salmo 18.
And it reads as this.
Lee de la siguiente manera.
I will love thee, O Lord, my strength.
Te amo, oh Jehová, fortaleza mía.
The Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer, my God, my strength, in whom I will trust, my buckler and the horn of my salvation and my high tower.
Jehová, roca mía y castillo mío y mi libertador, Dios mío, fortaleza mía, en él confiaré, mi escudo y la fuerza de mi salvación, mi alto refugio.
I will call upon the name of the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemies.
Invocaré a Jehová, quien es digno de ser alabado, y seré salvo de mis enemigos.
Let us bow our heads to start service.
Vamos a inclinar nuestros rostros para comenzar el servicio.
Heavenly Father,
Padre Celestial,
we're thankful today, Lord Jesus,
estamos agradecidos en esta tarde,
that you've given us the strength, Lord,
que nos diste la fuerza,
to come to service once again, Lord,
de venir al servicio una vez más, Señor.
We come, Lord, this afternoon, Lord,
venimos en esta tarde,
to find rest, Father, Lord,
para encontrar reposo,
in you, Lord Jesus,
en ti, Señor Jesús.
We ask you that your Holy Spirit come and visit us, Lord.
Te pedimos que tu Espíritu Santo venga y nos visite.
And speak to us, Father, Lord.
Y nos hable, Señor.
We surrender everything we have unto thee, Lord.
Rendimos todo ante ti, Señor.
We love you, Lord.
Y te amamos.
We thank you for all things.
Gracias por todas las cosas.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
En el nombre del Señor Jesucristo.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Who's ready to worship the Lord? Let's sing I'll Fly Away.
God bless you. Wasn't that beautiful? It's such a privilege once again to be standing here before you on this Sunday afternoon. The weather may be nearly 110 degrees, but we thank the Lord for all of it. That way we can appreciate the times of the year that He gives us as well. When we find the respite from the heat, we have respite from that heat. Right here in His house. And tonight, it's also a privilege to continue the series of excerpts we've been doing on the series of books called Supernatural, The Life of William Branham. We're in book two, The Young Man and His Desperation, 1933 to 1946. We currently find ourselves completing the second half of chapter 23, entitled Struggling Back. Before we start, a brief comment. Brother Branham was trying to make sense of many things in his life, and he was trying to put his life in order after the tragedies that befell him. He had some questions in his mind, and true to form, Brother Branham always seeked the Lord when he needed an answer. And he waited on the Lord for that answer, as we'll see in the second half of this chapter. to pick up where we left off and let you know how the previous half of the chapter ended, Brother Brandon was going through his mind over the various people he met at Mishawaka and how they were still producing manifestations in the works of God and showing, displaying the spirits and the gifts. However, their lives were vastly different. He wondered how could that be? And so we'll get started. Taking a few days off from his job, Bill drove north on Highway 62 until he came to the Tunnel Mill area. He parked his car off the road, waded across 14 Mile Creek, and hiked into the woods. Autumn flaunted her beauty. Orange, brown, and red leaves rustled above and crunched below him as he walked. Birds filled the background with their soft concertos. Eventually, Bill came to the place where that 80-foot-deep ravine dropped away from a sheer limestone cliff. He picked his way through the brush and boulders along the base of the cliff until he came to the mouth of his cave. There was a thin, pointed rock jutting up like a tooth in the front of the hole. He lit his candle, then wiggled into the opening feet first. Following the winding corridor 25 feet back into the hillside, he stopped to stare again at the upside-down pyramid-shaped rock poised above that rectangular limestone table. It amazed him every time he saw it. He set his coat and a few extra candles down on the ledge that he used for a bed. Then he took his Bible and went back outside to seek God in the warm fall sunlight. A fallen oak tree lay on the ground not far from the cave's entrance. The spot where the trunk of the old tree forked into the branches now formed a natural lounge chair. Bill nestled in that fork all afternoon, reading his Bible and praying. Eventually, the sky dimmed and the stars appeared. A light but chilly autumn breeze forced him to take shelter inside his cave. The next morning, he didn't stir until the sun rose high enough to warm his spot. He had left his Bible lying open in the fork of the dead oak, and the wind had blown its pages over to Hebrews, the 6th chapter. Bill straddled the tree trunk and read, "For it is impossible for those who were once enlightened and have tasted the heavenly gift and were made partakers of the Holy Ghost and have tasted the good word of God and the powers of the world to come, if they shall fall away, to renew them again unto repentance, seeking they crucify themselves the Son of God afresh and put him to an open shame. For the earth which drinketh in the rain that cometh oft upon it and bringeth forth herbs meet for them by whom it is dressed receiveth blessing from God. But that which beareth thorns and briars is rejected and nigh unto cursing, whose end is to be burned." That didn't make any sense to him. He turned the pages looking for a certain scripture in 2 Timothy that had been on his mind. When he took his hands off the Bible, a gust of wind blew the pages back to Hebrews chapter 6. He thought, how strange. Was God trying to tell him something with this portion of scripture? He read chapter 6 again, but it still didn't make sense to him. Walking back to his cave, he climbed down through the hole and made his way along the narrow passage to the place where the inverted pyramid of limestone hung over the rectangular rock table. Bill knelt and prayed, "Lord, what does Hebrews chapter 6 mean? What are you trying to tell me?" Suddenly, his fingers grew numb, not from the coolness of the cave. It was that benumbing feeling that often preceded a vision. His arms and legs felt heavy and his lips felt thick as though a dentist had just given him a shot of Novocaine. When he opened his eyes, he saw a world turning on its axis. The ground looked like a freshly plowed field. From around the edge of this revolving planet came a man dressed in white, carrying a big sack at his side. After every few steps, this man would scoop a handful of seeds from his sack and scatter them across the ground with a fling of his arm. As soon as he disappeared around the curvature of the earth, Bill saw another man, this one dressed in black, slinking along behind the first. This second man also had a sack at his side and was scattering seeds as he tiptoed through the field. He kept whipping his head from side to side as though he was doing something wrong and was afraid of being caught. After this man in black had passed around the curvature of the world, Bill saw the seeds germinate and grow rapidly to their full height. Now it became evident what the seeds were. Some were wheat, and others were cockleburrs, thistles, and stinkweeds. Out came the sun, baking the field and sucking all the moisture from the soil. Both wheat and weeds hung their heads together, panting and praying desperately for rain. Lower and lower, the plants sagged toward the parched earth. Then Bill saw a huge dark cloud come boiling over the horizon. As the rain poured down, the wheat straightened up and shouted, "Glory to God! Praise the Lord!" At the same time, the cockleburrs and stinkweeds sprang up straight and hollered, "Glory! Hallelujah! Praise the Lord!" The entire world was suddenly alive with plants bobbing in the rain, all screaming the same thing, "Praise the Lord!" Then the vision left him. Bill felt exhilarated. Now he understood Hebrews chapter 6. For it is impossible for those who were made partakers of the Holy Ghost, if they shall fall away, to renew them again unto repentance. For the earth which drinketh in the rain receiveth blessing from God, but that which beareth thorns and briars is rejected. That was his answer. The same rain that makes the wheat grow also waters the cockleburrs and stinkweeds. And the same Holy Spirit that blesses and feeds the Christian can also bless a hypocrite. It's just that the hypocrite will manifest a different fruit. It all depended upon the seed that was planted. Bill thought about something Jesus said. Love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you, and pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you, that ye may be the children of your Father which is in heaven. For he maketh his sun to rise on the evil and on the good, and sendeth rain on the just and on the unjust. As it was in the natural, so it was in the spiritual. That explained why Jesus declared, many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name, and in thy name have cast out devils, and in thy name done many wonderful works? And then I will profess unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that work iniquity. Even though these people showed outward signs of the power of God, their inner motives were faulty or corrupt. Bill left his cave, finally understanding that there were two spirits operating within the framework of the church, drawing their life from the same source, but heading in opposite directions. Like the grafting of foreign limbs into the parent tree, they would all draw their life from the same trunk. An orange tree, therefore, support the branches from a lemon or a lime or a grapefruit tree. All the foreign branches might look like they belong to the orange tree. Yet, when they produced their fruit, the lemon branch would bear lemons, the lime branch limes. Likewise, there would always be people in the Christian church who would draw their life from the Holy Spirit trunk, but their fruit would be self-interest or politics or self-righteous legalism or hypocrisy, anything except the fruit of the Holy Spirit. Nevertheless, if that parent trunk ever sprouted a new branch of its own, it would bear oranges. Jesus said in John 15, verse 5, I am the vine, ye are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit, for without me ye can do nothing. Paul wrote, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Jesus insisted, by their fruits ye shall know them. Now that he understood the difference between those two men at Mishawaka who had demonstrated tongues and interpretations so dramatically, Bill began to relax his attitude toward the gifts of the Spirit and outward showings of emotion. On December 31st, 1939, he held a watch night service at his church to usher in 1940. He had a blackboard set up on the platform and drew out a biblical timeline of the second coming of Christ as best as he knew how. A group of Pentecostal people had come across the river from Louisville to attend his service. When Bill took an intermission from teaching, some of the women in this group wanted to sing a special selection. It turned out to be quite a combo. One woman played cymbals, another one beat on tin cans. Another woman played a washboard with thimbles on her fingers, and the fourth woman banged away at the piano. They played a fast song, and the congregation sang the words, "There is going to be a meeting in the air, in the sweet, sweet by and by. I am going to meet you over there, in that home beyond the sky. Such singing you will hear, never heard by mortal ear. 'Twill be glorious, I do declare, and God's own Son will be the leading one at that meeting in the air." In the swirl and jangle of music, a blonde teenage girl sprang from her seat and danced in the aisle. Bill sat in the seat of the scornful, criticizing her in his heart, thinking, "There is nothing of God about that. She is just making a show. She just wants to be seen. She is making a tavern out of my church." Another girl joined the first, then another. Bill thought, "Now wait a minute. I wonder if there is any scripture for dancing." He remembered how Miriam, when she saw Pharaoh's army drowned in the Red Sea, picked up a tambourine and danced along the shore, rejoicing in victory, and the daughters of Israel followed her dancing. Then Bill remembered how King David, when the Ark of the Covenant was returned to Jerusalem, danced before the Lord with all his might. Bill thought, "Maybe I don't have enough victory in me yet." So as he sat on the platform, he let his starchy Baptist foot start tapping to the music. Soon his hands were clapping. Before the song ended, he was jumping in the aisle, dancing with the others. Learning from that experience, Bill prayed, "God, take me out of the seat of the scornful. From now on, let me look on everything sensibly before I pass judgment." It was a simple prayer, but one that would have far-reaching consequences. He was moving again down the road towards his destiny. God bless you.
God bless Brother Fred, amen.
Que Dios bendiga a nuestro hermano Fred, amen.
Amen, would you please stand?
¿Se pueden poner de pie, por favor?
If you would please just turn around, greet your neighbor, give him a smile, say God bless you.
Voltee y saluda a su vecino, dígale Dios te bendiga.
God bless you. Welcome to Children's Church.
Bienvenido a la iglesia de los niños, servicio de los niños.
Fred.
Brother Fred, bless you, sir.
Amen. It's good to see each and every one of you this afternoon.
Es muy bueno mirar a cada uno de ustedes en esta tarde.
Here in the house of the Lord.
Aquí en la casa del Señor.
We greet you on behalf of our pastor, Brother Bernie.
Le saludamos en nombre de nuestro pastor, hermano Bernabé.
And the Children's Church.
Y el departamento de Iglesia de los Niños.
Are you ready to hear from the Lord this evening?
¿Están listos para hablar de escuchar de parte del Señor en esta tarde?
Amen. It's good. Amen. As I said, it's good to see each and every one of you.
Como les comentaba, es muy agradable ver a cada uno de ustedes en esta tarde.
I am thankful to the Lord.
Estoy muy agradecido con el Señor.
For so many things.
Por tantas cosas.
For His mercy.
Por su misericordia.
His grace.
Su gracia.
His love.
Su amor.
You know, all the things that He gives us.
Todas las cosas que Él nos da.
He is truly good to us.
Él es muy bueno con nosotros.
It's encouraging.
Él nos anima.
To know.
El saber.
That we can come here to God's house.
Que podemos venir aquí a la casa de Dios.
And open up our hearts.
Y abrir nuestro corazón.
Leave our cares outside.
Dejar nuestros pesares allá afuera.
And come and see what He has for us.
Y ver lo que Él tiene para nosotros.
What a privilege it is, amen.
Qué gran privilegio es ese, amen.
It's really good.
Es algo muy bueno.
I ask God that He bless each and every one of you.
Le pido a Dios que bendiga a cada uno de ustedes.
And may His love and His mercy and His Holy Spirit.
Y que su amor, su misericordia, su Espíritu Santo.
Always abide with you.
Siempre more con ustedes.
And in you.
Y en ustedes,
in your homes,
en sus hogares,
and everywhere you go,
y a todo lugar donde vayan.
We have one Thanksgiving this afternoon.
Tenemos un agradecimiento en esta tarde.
The Flores family is giving thanks to the Lord.
La familia Flores le da gracias al Señor.
for Sister Daniela's report.
Por el reporte que recibieron de parte de nuestra hermana Daniela.
You know, she had a problem with her knee.
Tuvo un problema con su rodilla ella.
But the Lord is good, amen.
Pero el Señor es bueno, amen.
And he came through for them, amen.
Y él les ayudó, amen.
And we're thankful for that.
Estamos muy agradecidos por eso.
How many of you have a need this evening?
¿Cuántos tenemos una necesidad en esa tarde?
Amen. I know I'm needy, amen.
Yo sé que soy necesitado, amen.
Amen. We're going to be going before the Lord and in prayer.
Vamos a venir ante el Señor en oración.
And we're going to be asking him for all the needs.
Vamos a pedirle por toda necesidad.
So if you have something in your heart,
así que si hay algo en su corazón,
anything,
cualquier cosa,
you need something,
ocupa algo,
you're thankful for something,
le agradece por algo,
or you know somebody that needs something,
o sea, conoce a alguien que necesita algo,
let's keep them in prayer.
Vamos a mantenerlos en oración.
Let us bow our heads, brothers and sisters.
Inclinemos nuestros rostros, hermanos.
Our heavenly Father, Lord Jesus.
Nuestro Padre celestial, Señor Jesús.
Father, we come before you this evening, Lord.
Venimos ante ti en esta tarde, Señor.
Father, with a humble and contrite heart, Lord.
Con un corazón contrito y humillado, Señor.
We're so thankful, Father God, that you're so merciful to us, Lord.
Estamos muy agradecidos que tienes tanta misericordia con nosotros.
Father, we're thankful, Father.
Te agradecemos, Padre.
For that sacrifice on Calvary, Lord.
Por el sacrificio en el Calvario.
Father, that it continues, Father,
que aún continúas, Padre,
to save us, Lord,
salvándonos,
to heal us, Lord,
sanándonos,
to comfort us, Lord,
y consolándonos,
to give us joy, Lord,
para darnos gozo.
All of those things that your Spirit bears, Father,
todas esas cosas que tu Espíritu provee, Señor,
we're thankful for all of them, Lord.
Te agradecemos por todo eso.
Father, give us the courage, Lord,
danos el valor, Señor,
to continue to speak and ask you for the things that we need, Father.
Para continuar hablando y pidiéndote las cosas que necesitamos, Señor.
And to be thankful, Father.
Y continuar agradecidos.
And to praise you, Lord.
Y adorarte, Señor.
Because only you are worthy to be praised, Lord.
Porque
Jesus.
Porque solamente tú eres digno de adoración, Señor.
Father, may your Spirit just be amongst us this evening, Lord.
Que tu Espíritu esté entre nosotros en esta tarde.
Father, in this little simple service, Lord.
En ese servicio sencillo, Señor.
We ask you for all things, Father.
Te pedimos todas las cosas.
For our brothers and sisters on the internet, Lord.
Por nuestros hermanos y hermanas que nos ven por la internet.
Answer their prayers, Lord.
Contesta sus oraciones, Señor.
Father, bless the offering.
Y bendice la ofrenda.
The cheerful giver, Lord.
Al dador alegre, Padre.
We ask you all these things in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Todo eso lo pedimos en el nombre del Señor Jesucristo.
Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated. He is Jehovah, God of creation. He is Jehovah, Lord God Almighty, the Balm of Gilead. Jehovah, God of creation. See?
Bernie D. Garcia III.
We make
please stand.
Ponele pie, por favor.
Struggling, look to somebody and tell them, when he was on the cross, tell him, you were on his mind.
You were on his mind.
How many believe that? Hey, can you imagine? Jesus Christ.
Jesucristo.
God in flesh.
El Dios en carne.
The Word.
La palabra.
That came down to be born in a human body.
Que descendió a ser nacido en un cuerpo humano.
God.
Dios.
Who left his throne in glory.
Que dejó su trono en la gloria.
Who here would give up their house for somebody else?
Le daría su casa a alguien más aquí.
Or your bed.
O su cama.
Your brother comes over, he needs a place to stay. Here, buddy, you can have my bed.
Que tu hermano venga y que ocupe donde quedarse. Mira, quédate con mi cama.
A la sofa.
Go to the couch.
Right? The couch. Ahí está la sala.
There's a living room.
Hey, una almohada, unos cobijas.
There's a pillow, some blankets.
Not my bed.
Mi cama no.
Shoot, my bed's Tempur-Pedic.
Mi cama es de colchón fino.
But God Almighty,
pero Dios Todopoderoso,
gave up his throne,
dio su trono,
the songs of the angels,
las canciones de los ángeles,
everything,
todo lo dejó,
golden streets,
las calles de oro,
pearly gates,
las puertas de perlas,
crystal seas,
los mares de cristal,
gave it up,
lo dio todo,
to come and hang on a tree,
para venir a ser colgado en un árbol,
for you,
en un madero. Por usted.
For you.
Por usted allá atrás.
For you in the front.
Por usted aquí enfrente.
He gave it up for us.
Lo dio por todo por nosotros.
Woo! If that don't make somebody go nuts, I don't know what will.
Si eso no lo vuelve, no lo hace brincar, no sé qué lo hará entonces.
And when he was on the cross dying,
cuando él estaba muriendo en esa cruz,
I would have been like, I gave my life for these ungrateful people.
Yo estuviera pensando, yo di mi vida por estos ingratos.
And they hung me on a cross.
Que me pusieron en la cruz.
Thank God that I'm not God.
Gracias a Dios que yo no soy Dios.
Because I would have been too chicken. Nobody would have been saved.
Porque yo no hubiera podido haberlo hecho. Nadie hubiera sido salvado.
I'm a coward.
Yo soy un cobarde.
But God made us more than conquerors.
Pero Dios nos hizo conquistadores.
He came and said,
él vino y dijo,
I died for Benji.
Morí por Benji.
I died for Karen.
Morí por Karen.
I'm dying for the Facio family.
Morí por la familia Facio.
I died for brother Jeff.
Por el hermano Jeff también.
For Caleb.
Por Caleb.
For sister Maria.
Por la hermana Maria.
For brother Chris and sister Patricia.
La hermano Chris y Patricia.
For sister Sarah on the
por
piano.
Por la hermana Sarah aquí en el piano también.
I died for them because I love them.
Yo morí por todos porque yo les amo. Amen.
And when he was on the cross.
Y cuando estaba en la cruz.
You and I,
usted y yo,
were on
estábamos
his mind.
En su mente. Amen.
How many love him this evening?
¿Cuántos
for
le
that?
Aman en esta tarde?
Amen. Can we give him a hand of praise?
Vamos a darle un aplauso.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Dígale.
Amen.
Amen. Con ganas.
Amen.
Amen.
Because he is worthy, amen.
Porque él es digno.
Amen. Thank amen. You, Lord God.
Gracias, Señor Dios.
Amen. Amen. Praise God.
Gloria a Dios.
Can you look over to your neighbor and say, thank you for coming to Children's
Church.
Puede
decir al vecino, gracias por venir a la iglesia de los niños.
Tell God bless you.
Dígale, Dios les bendiga.
God bless you, brother Alex. Thank you for coming.
Les bendiga, hermano Alex. Gracias por venir.
Sister Berceda, thank you for the beautiful violin playing.
Gracias por la música hermosa del violín.
The musicians.
A los músicos.
Very, very cool. Such a blessing, amen.
Es una gran bendición tenerlos, amen.
You may be seated.
Pueden tomar asiento.
Amen. Praise is a powerful thing.
La adoración es algo poderoso.
Amen.
Amen.
Walking out here with you all praising.
Cuando salimos de aquí todos adorando.
That blesses us.
Eso nos bendice.
That blesses me.
A mí me bendice.
See, when we praise.
Cuando adoramos.
Chains can be broken.
Las cadenas son quebrantadas. Amen.
If you don't believe me,
ahora si no me cree eso,
ask somebody that's been spiritually in prison.
Pregúntale a alguien que ha estado imprisionado en una prisión espiritual.
All right, everybody look around. Okay,
todos vamos a mirar alrededor.
Okay, when I was a little kid,
cuando yo era niño,
if I would look back in the pews at church,
si yo miraba las bancas en la iglesia,
my mom would pinch me.
Mi mamá me pellizcaba si volteaba para atrás.
You do not look back in church. You look up at the person preaching. You look up.
Me decía, tú no puedes voltear para atrás, ahí enfrente con el que predicador.
Be respectful.
Hay que tener respeto, me decía.
But this time the minister is asking you.
Pero esta vez el ministro les pide a ustedes, niños.
So mom, dads, no pinch nobody, please.
Así que papás, mamás, no los vayan a pellizcar.
Okay, ready? I just saved you, so you don't get pinched, okay?
Se acabó de salvar para que no le pellizquen.
I'm sure your mom can give you a good one.
Tu mamá te va a dar uno si no.
She has a lot of kids, so she's probably used to that.
Tiene muchos hijos y está acostumbrada a pellizcar.
So, I want you to look around at all the hands that are lifted up, okay, kids?
Quiero que volteen y vean todas las manos que están levantadas.
I'm going to ask a question, and then I want you to see how many hands lift up.
Voy a preguntar y quiero que miren cuántas manos han levantado.
If you've ever been spiritually imprisoned,
si usted ha sido aprisionado espiritualmente,
raise your hand.
Levante su mano.
Now, so you guys see that? Look around.
¿Ven eso, niños?
And parents, look around too, so you see you're not the only one.
Los papás también miren para que vean que no son los únicos.
Now, if the Lord has delivered you from those prisons,
ahora si Dios le ha liberado de esas prisiones,
stand up so we can see that.
Póngase
too.
De pie para que podamos mirar eso.
Woo!
Amen.
Amen. Look at everybody standing up.
Mire todos las personas de pie.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. Now, how many have been delivered? Okay, you leave your hand up. Good
levante
job.
Sus manos.
One hand.
Una mano.
Now, raise up your second hand.
Levante la otra mano.
If in that prison,
si en esa prisión,
in those chains,
en esas cadenas,
in that depression or in that sorrow,
la depresión, la tristeza,
praise helped you break out of it.
La adoración le ayudó a salir de ellas.
You can lift your other hand if you can testify to that. Look around, amen.
Alrededor.
The testimonies that are standing up.
Aquí están los testimonios parados.
Can we give a hand of praise for those testimonies?
¿Podemos darle un aplauso a esos testimonios?
For God who made that possible.
Porque Dios lo hizo posible.
Amen. Woo. You may be seated.
Pueden tomar asiento.
I love that.
A mí me encanta eso.
Praise God.
Gloria a Dios.
You know why that encourages me, kids?
¿Sabe por qué me da ánimo, niños?
Because that tells me that God,
eso me dice que Dios,
is real.
Es real.
Amen. And that His word,
y que su palabra,
is true.
Es la verdad.
I'm gonna say that again, because that tells me God,
eso me dice que Dios,
is real.
Es real.
And His word,
y su palabra,
is true.
Es la verdad.
So I want you to say that with me.
Dígame eso conmigo.
God is real. And His word is
the truth.
True. En español,
Dios es real.
Yeah.
Y su palabra es la verdad.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank God that we don't serve a fake God.
Qué bueno que no servimos a un Dios falso.
Thank God that we don't serve a fake God.
Gracias a Dios que no servimos a un Dios falso.
You know, somebody in the Bible,
¿sabe alguien en la Biblia,
that loved to testify and worship the Lord?
Le encantaba testificar y adorar al Señor.
His name was Paul.
Su nombre era Pablo.
He was in prison one time.
Una vez él estaba aprisionado.
And he started worshiping God.
Y comenzó a adorar a Dios.
And something amazing happened. Who
y
knows
algo
what
increíble
happened?
Pasó. ¿Recuerda?
Does somebody know what happened?
¿Alguien sabe qué pasó?
When he was in prison.
Cuando estaba en la prisión.
You know?
¿Tú sabes?
Can you tell us?
Que nos diga, por favor.
The jail broke.
La cárcel se quebró.
Can we give him a round of applause?
Vamos a darle un aplauso, amén.
That's awesome.
Eso es tremendo.
How many love to praise the Lord?
¿Cuántos les gusta adorar al Señor? Amen.
How many love to testify?
¿Cuántos les gusta testificar?
So before service, I talked to a few kids who wanted to give testimonies.
Antes del servicio, hablé con unos niños que querían dar testimonios.
How many were here for our last children's service?
¿Cuántos estuvieron aquí durante los últimos servicios de los niños?
I have a couple of the actors that were in those skits.
Tengo unos cuantos de los actores que estuvieron en esas obras.
And they said they wanted to come up and they were willing to share a testimony about their experience.
Y quieren subir, están dispuestos a compartir un testimonio de su experiencia.
Would we like to hear that? Is that okay?
¿Escuchar eso? ¿Está bien?
Amen. So those kids, those brave young kids, if you want to come up now.
Niños valientes que si pueden pasar ahora.
We're going to go ahead and do that. Thank you.
Vamos a hacer eso,
they're kind of nervous. Can we make them feel welcome up
here? Están un poquito nerviosos. ¿Les podemos dar una bienvenida, por favor?
Amen. Look at these awesome volunteers.
Miren esos voluntarios tan tremendos. Amen.
Now, before they share their little testimonies,
antes de compartir su testimonio,
I want to share the story of Paul and Silas in prison.
Yo quisiera compartir la historia de Pablo y Silas.
But I'm going to need help.
Pero ocupo ayuda.
You look like a good Paul. Can you help me, Benji?
¿Tú te miras como un buen Pablo? ¿Me ayudas, Benji?
Can you make him feel welcome?
¿Lo puedes hacer? ¿Se siente bienvenido? Póngase de pie, por favor.
Good, thank you, Brother Benji. You're going to make a great Paul. Just go ahead and stand right here. Chody doesn't know, but he's Silas.
Oh, yo no sabía, pero yo soy Silas, parece.
But Paul and Silas, before they got into a prison, did you guys know that there was a fortune teller?
Pero antes de que le llegaran a la prisión, ¿sabían que había una divina?
Did you know that the Bible talks about fortune tellers and magic?
Que la Biblia habla sobre las adivinas y los la magia también.
It's not just on Disney Channel.
No es en el canal de Disney, de la tele.
But the Bible tells us the real story.
La historia de verdad.
So I need a fortune teller and her slave master.
Ocupo una divina y su amo.
Sister Patricia, Brother Chris,
a dos.
Can you help us out, please?
¿Nos ayudan, por favor?
Thank you. It's for the good of the colony.
Es para, amen.
Thank you very much.
Muchas gracias.
But there were Roman soldiers. Does anybody think they make good Roman soldiers?
Había soldados también. ¿Algunos soldados romanos por aquí?
Brother Lázaro, I know you're not Roman, you're Mexican, Lázaro, but you
no
can
romano,
come.
Es mexicano, pero pues bueno.
It's Latin.
Es latino.
Can you give him a round of applause as well?
Puede darle un aplauso también a su hermano. Amen.
Now, while our children testify to us,
mientras los niños testifican,
our story can be found in Acts chapter 16, verse 16.
Nuestra historia puede encontrarse en el libro de los Hechos, capítulo 16, versículo 16.
So I have these two Bibles here I'm going to give to these lovely volunteers.
Aquí tenemos unas Biblias que les vamos a entregar a los voluntarios.
So they can refresh their memory about the story.
Para que puedan refrescar su memoria sobre la historia.
And we're going to dramatize that for
y
you.
Y vamos a hacer un pequeño drama
is
con
that
esto.
Okay?
¿Está bien?
So here's a Bible for you, Acts 16, verse 16.
Hechos 16,
Acts
16.
16, verse 16. So we have Paul, we have a Roman
Pablo,
soldier,
un soldado romano,
we have a slave master,
tenemos un amo de esclavos,
and the fortune teller.
Y una divina también.
Can we give them one more last round of applause?
Un aplauso una vez
amen.
Más, por favor.
So you guys can go ahead and have a seat. You can look through the Bible, just read the story so you know what you're going to be doing. And now let's hear these young children's testimonies. Amen.
Ahora vamos a escuchar los testimonios de los kids. Pequeñitos. Amen.
Can we stand in a straight line right here?
Vamos a ponernos en línea aquí, por favor.
All right. Let's have James come first.
A ver, vamos aquí a James.
You ready to share something with us, James?
Well, the experience from my play was that I really liked it because it shows how Brother Branham and healed the little baby with a big head. And that goes to show that when we are sick or we have big heads, that God can heal us.
Eso, la experiencia de la obra a mí me gustó mucho porque el hermano Bran nos muestra que pudo sanar a ese bebé con la cabeza grande y eso a mí me demuestra que Dios puede sanar cualquier cosa, incluyendo las cabezas grandes.
Amen. Thank you, James. Isn't that awesome?
Pues eso es tremendo.
Brother Alex, that was so deep. He has no idea. He said God can heal us when we have big heads.
El hermano es algo tan tremendo que ni siquiera se dio cuenta lo que dijo que puede sanar las cabezas grandes.
That's true.
Es la verdad.
What I remember about my play is that not my play, but the eagle. He had to go to a rock and beat all the crust off, and that's us when we have to go to God and get rid of like. And ask him to forgive us for our sins.
Entonces la obra de del águila a mí me gustó porque es cuando el águila tiene que ir a la montaña, a la roca y golpearse para librarse de esa, de toda esa costra que tiene. Y es como nosotros cuando nosotros vamos a Dios y pedimos a Él, a la roca, y Él nos libra del pecado que es esa costra.
Amen.
Favorite part was when the baby got healed, and God is the God of miracles, and he makes miracles to human and animals.
Entonces a mí me gustó la obra del bebé, cuando Dios sanó al bebé, porque sabemos que Dios es un Dios de milagros y Dios puede sanar a los humanos, a la gente y a los animales también.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Gloria a Dios. Amén.
When I was doing my play, I'm more struggling at school, and I always have pressure on my chest, and I always told God to help me.
Entonces a mí me gustó la obra porque le estaba mirando la obra. Yo me acordaba que yo cuando yo estoy en la escuela me gusta pedirle a Dios que Él me ayude.
And did he help you?
Yes.
Y Dios me ayudó.
And did he help you relieve the pressure?
Yes.
Ayudó a sacar la presión.
Amen.
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 What I learned from the play is that every time you have like a lot of pressures or problems, you just give it to God and He'll like deal it for you.
Lo que aprendí de la obra es que cada vez que tengamos problemas y presión, hay que acudir a Dios y Él lo resolverá para nosotros.
Amen. He relieves us from that pressure.
Él nos salva, nos suelta esa presión.
For me, I had the cast of the mom, and they gave me the role late. And I had to memorize all the lines, and I was scared I wasn't gonna do right. And then that night I went home and I prayed to God, and I said, Lord, help me. Help me memorize these lines, and not mess up in the play. And the morning that I woke up, on the day of the play, I woke up and I said, okay, I'm ready. And so I went to church and I did the play. And once I said that line, God practically just let off the pressure from me.
Amen.
Entonces yo en ir a la obra me dieron el papel de la mamá con el bebito que estaba enfermo, y yo estaba nerviosa porque no sabía, me dieron tantas líneas para memorizarme, no sabía si lo podía hacer. Y esa noche fui a mi casa y me puse a orarle al Señor, y a la mañana siguiente cuando desperté yo me sentí lista. Dije, bueno, yo estoy lista. Fui al servicio esa noche, di a la obra entonces, y cuando yo pasé a hacer mi papel, dije las líneas, y Dios me ayudó a sacar la presión en ese momento.
Amen. Thank you, mija. Thank you very much.
Qué tremendas palabras. Amen.
How many adults can relate to feeling nervous about something?
¿Cuántos adultos se pueden sentir nerviosos en el pasado por alguna razón?
And if we could just remember that out of the mouth of babes.
Si recordamos que de la boca de niños.
She said she prayed and said, "Lord, help me."
Dice que ella oró y dijo, "Señor, ayúdame."
And the next thing she knew, it was over.
Y cuando se dio cuenta, ya había terminado todo.
And the pressure was off.
La presión se había ido.
Amen.
Amen.
Instead of testifying, may I sing a song?
She wants to know if instead of testifying, can she sing a song?
Ella quiere saber si en vez de testificar puede cantar.
Would that be okay, saints? Wouldn't that be beautiful?
Está bien, ¿no es hermoso?
And I'll sing with you, so you're not nervous, okay?
Vamos a cantar con ella para que no se ponga nerviosa.
Thank you. mi fuerza eres tú, Jehová. Tú eres Dios poderoso y mi fuerza eres tú, Jehová. Tú sabes bien que cansado estoy, que es contigo voy en el viento, en el frío. Y no temeré, es Dios en universo, y él sé que estás conmigo en el valle, en las montañas más altas. Tú eres grande, tú eres grande, Dios. En el valle, en las montañas más altas, tú eres grande, Dios. Tú eres Dios poderoso y mi fuerza eres tú, Jehová.
Thank you.
Praise God.
Amen.
And it's just an improvised service. Thank the Lord. Amen.
De improviso. Gracias a Dios.
Thank you.
Amen.
That was beautiful. That was a treat.
Algo hermoso. Fue algo bonito.
How many believe that He's the same yesterday, today, and forever?
¿Cuántos creen que eres el mismo ayer, hoy y por siempre?
He's still Jehovah.
Él sigue siendo Jehová.
How many were blessed by those testimonies?
¿Cuántos fueron bendecidos por los testimonios?
And that song.
Y ese bonito canto.
Can we encourage our children one more time?
Vamos a animar a nuestros niños.
For volunteering.
Por ser voluntarios. Amen.
Amen. So now,
ahora,
let's hear about this Bible story.
Vamos a escuchar esta historia de la Biblia.
So we can see proof from the end. You don't just want to hear what I say.
Ustedes no quieren solamente escuchar lo que yo digo.
We want to know from the Bible.
Queremos verlo de la Biblia.
That praise works.
Que la adoración funciona.
Amen.
Amen.
If not, it's just a theory.
Si no es una teoría solamente.
But let's read it from the Bible.
Vamos so we a leerlo de la Biblia. Aquí tenemos a Pablo entonces.
And we had Silas.
Y a Silas.
And they were going around, they were preaching the gospel. There they go, preaching. They got their Bibles, they're ready to go. They just got filled with the Holy Ghost. So for days they traveled, Paul and Silas, preaching to people, converting them. And in this one town where they were going, there was this man. There was this man who had a slave. And that slave, she had a gift. She was demon possessed, but she can tell the future. And here they are, here he comes.
Hello. Hello, my name is William McRabbit. I got that name because my teeth. Have you ever wondered who's gonna win the elections this year? Or have you ever wondered about your finances? Have you, mate? Well, you see here. Or have you ever wondered about romance? Who are you gonna end up marrying? What about you, boy in the orange? Have you ever wondered? Well, for 2 shillings, she can tell you the answer. I promise. I have some testimonials. One time I had a friend, he had a little grasshopper. He had a grasshopper and he thought, should I build a pool in my backyard? So I said, why don't, for 2 shillings, ask my fortune teller. And he denied. And you know what happened? He built the pool and his grasshopper drowned. And then I had a friend who had 2 business proposals and he chose one. Well, he chose the one that my fortune teller told him to choose. And he became a millionaire. But the other people, the other proposal, they were going to kill him. Now they're in prison. You hear that? So this is my fortune teller again for 2 shillings. Just 2. You, I like your green shirt. 2 for 1. 2 fortunes for one. For 1 shilling.
He's an empty horse, brothers.
So as he was trying to sell his fortune teller, the Bible says that she followed Paul and Silas.
I know who you are. You're going to tell us the way to salvation. I know who you are. They're God's servants. They're going to tell us the way to salvation.
So this creepy lady was following Paul and Silas everywhere. And she was saying the truth. She was saying, this is God's servant. He's going to tell us the way to salvation. And you know what? Something funny. The Bible actually says, La Biblia dice que Paul got annoyed. That she was getting on his nerves following, even though she was saying the right thing. He was getting annoyed. How many here ever get annoyed? You're getting on my last nerve. So for days, the Bible said, for days she followed him.
I know who you are. But I know who you are. You're God's servants.
Until Paul got so annoyed, he came and grabbed the microphone for me so he can speak.
I know who you are.
Because he wanted to make sure everybody heard.
I command thee in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, thou spirit, come out of her.
So right there, Paul turned around and said, "Get out! I command you to get out." And the spirit left her. The Bible said the spirit left.
I don't.
I wonder if she can still tell the future.
How many hands do I have? How many fingers do I have behind my back? How many hands do I have behind my back? Answer that.
No, she can't anymore.
I bet this guy got kind of...
I can't believe it. What'd you do? Who's gonna... Put your hands behind... Wait, how many fingers do I have behind my back? What you mean? I have two. How am I gonna make money now? I can't believe it. Who am I gonna marry? Tell me. You don't know? I bet it's someone from Africa. What do I do? You! You, come here. Come here. Yes, you. No, your son. Yeah. Okay. Come here. The magistrates, you know, was there any other soldiers I was supposed to, you know what? Oh, you, both of you guys, come here. Okay, they've got these Jewish people who are coming and they are telling us customs that are against the law because we're Romans and we cannot observe them too. Arrest them and beat them in the city. Go!
Pretend they're not your dads. So the short midget soldiers beat them up and they drug them to prison.
I will still serve you, Lord Jesus.
Amen, that's right, you can't stop the word.
No.
So Joham stopped hitting his dad and he picked him up and he walked him to the platform because that's where the prison is, where our trusty Roman soldier is over here. Nice and strapping, young and handsome Roman soldier. So they beat up the men of God who were preaching. Can you imagine? They cast out a demon and they get beat up for it. Man, if that happened to me, if I prayed for something and a demon got cast out and then they beat me up, I ain't never going to the altar again. I ain't never going to that church, but not these guys. They were soldiers. They got beat up and they got taken to prison. And the Bible says that they didn't sit down comfortably. So the Roman soldier kicked them off the bench and he tied them by their ankles and he put them in prison. And then he decided that prison is too close to the piano, so he brought them to center stage. Because that prison has couches. He wanted them right where everybody can just laugh at them and nobody, there's no way they can get out of this cell. Right over here. Right over here. There they were, enchained. And the leader of the soldier said, "Soldier, I want you to stand right here in the front. And I want you to guard this gate, see? Good job." He said, "Push." And if anything happens and these soldiers escape, guess what? I know your wife, she's sitting right over there. I know your daughter, she's sitting right over there. Where is she? Is that? I know where your family lives, and you're a soldier of the Roman government. So do me proud, or else I'll have to do you dirty. So you stand here and you guard this gate. Make sure they don't go anywhere. And all these soldiers over here, for some reason, they became prisoners. Go like this, guys. They're tied up. And they're going, "This prison is cold.
Prison's cold.
This prison's dirty.
This prison's dirty.
This prison hurts.
This prison hurts."
And they were complaining the entire time, Brother Alex. How many of us have been in a prison and we just complain? How many of us have been poor or been cold or been in depression and we've been sorrow? We've been in our own prison in our mind and we just complain about it. These prisoners were complaining. And these prisoners, they weren't moving so much because they were tied really tightly. They were very uncomfortable. But they didn't complain.
What do they do? I don't, let's see.
We're in for it now, my brother. This is it.
That's okay. I have an idea. You know, I thought I saw a rat, but I can't really see because it's so dark in here, Silas.
So cold, my brother.
Yeah.
We're gonna freeze to death in here.
Yeah. Maybe if we get closer to each other, we could warm each other up. You know, Silas, I'm pretty hungry. I wish I had a burrito right now.
We're cold. We're hungry. What are we gonna do? We might die.
No, we are not gonna die. I trust in the Lord. I know we trust in the Lord with all our hearts. And I know that the Lord has purposed for us to be here for some reason. I don't know yet, but I know it's got to be for a reason. How about we worship Him? Let's sing a song.
Yes.
I heard a song earlier today before we got chained up and beat up and for casting the dog. I heard someone sing and it just revived my heart.
That always comforts me, my brother. Please. Yeah. Please always comfort me.
We'll sing that song in, I don't know, is it F minor? He is Jehovah.
Oh, I love that song.
Oh, man, when that's I heard right. that song earlier, my heart jumped for joy, man.
Amen. Amen.
Silas, let's sing that song.
Let's sing it, amen.
He is Jehovah. You feel better? God, God Almighty. He's almighty, Silas. He's gonna heal our stripes. Oh, oh, yes, Lord Jesus. He is Jehovah. He's gonna heal us, Silas. He's gonna heal us. Oh, let's see.
So the more they sang, the more energetic they got. And the more they started to praise. And then all of a sudden, the tempo picked up. And they wanted to worship faster and faster and happier. And they got joyful. Because when you start worshiping, you get happy. Continued and the praise continued. They were worshiping and shouting glory. And everybody.
if you can tap in to God and release that energy through praise, you can be free. And that day, angels, they came. God sent a mighty angels to come and shake the walls of the prison. So they were shaking and shaking and shaking and shaking the walls of the prison. And they kept singing and singing.
He is Jehovah, the God that delivered me.
Sing hallelujah.
Sing hallelujah.
Prison bars had broken. Their dreams had been answered. Some of the prisoners wanted to escape, but the Bible said they didn't escape. So you got to get back up here. And then
the music got really, really soft because somebody knew that he just lost his job and probably his life.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Where's the prisoners? That is the prisoners.
We're all here. Fear not.
Oh my God.
He's about to kill himself.
They're gonna kill my wife and my daughter over there.
So he pulls out his sword.
Oh.
He pulled.
No. Oh. Fear not.
Let me die.
We are all here.
Let me die.
Fear not. We're all here. It's dark in here. Just bring a light and you can see for yourself.
So the prisoner, the Bible said he went to go get a light. So run and go get a light, brother. Chris has a light.
I can't find the light.
Bring the light. Oh, thanks. Oh.
Then,
oh my God. How should I be saved?
Did you hear what he said? He saw them. He witnessed the power of God. And he wasn't like, prove it. He was like, where can I find that on YouTube? No. He said, how can I be saved? ¿Cómo puedo ser salvado? How can I be saved?
How can I be saved?
Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ,
yes,
and thou shalt be saved,
amen,
and thy house.
Amen, that's right.
Amen. So Sister Abriel and Rory got saved because Brother Lazaro got saved. Can you raise your hand and be like, amen? Amen. And then the Bible says that they went to the house. And his family was saved and baptized.
Amen.
Hey, all because the power of praise. God came down. Can we please give God a hand of praise right now? Can we give our improvisers a round of applause, please?
Un aplauso a nuestros actores de improviso.
Brother Chris, sister, can you come up, please? You're saved now, amen? No more shiesty business.
Ya no más de negocios sucios.
No more fortune telling.
Nada más de adivinanza.
Sing hallelujah. Sing hallelujah. Sing hallelujah. Sing hallelujah.
He is Jehovah, Lord God Almighty.
Can you stand, please?
He's Jehovah, God of creation. He's Jehovah, Lord God Almighty. The God of creation, the rock of ages. He's Jehovah, the God that's willing to
sing hallelujah. So what's something that we learned?
¿Qué es algo que aprendimos entonces?
What's something that we can take away from here?
Algo que podemos tomar de todo lo que vimos.
Anyone want to raise your hands? We have so many volunteers.
¿Algún voluntario?
Thank you, sister.
El poder de la adoración.
The power of praise. Did you raise your hand, mijo?
¿Levantaste tu mano, mijo? A ver, venga para acá.
The power of praise.
El poder de la adoración.
You can take something out of the devil and then the devil gets mad.
Puede quitarle algo al diablo y el diablo se enoja.
What are we going to take away from the devil?
¿Qué le vamos a quitar al diablo entonces?
His horns.
His horns. Amen.
Amen.
Let's take away those horns and we're going to throw them on the floor and we're going to machacar la cabeza al diablo.
Y quitarle esos cuernos y pisatearlos los cuernos entonces.
Amen. I like that.
A mí me encantó eso.
I've never heard that one before, brother Alex.
Nunca había escuchado eso, hermano Alex.
Oh, take away his horns and
quitarle
get him mad.
Sus cuernos y se va a enojar él.
How many want to take away the devil's horns?
¿Cuántos le quieren quitar los cuernos al diablo?
Give him a good kick like the Lord
Dale
Jesus
una buena
did.
Patada como Jesús lo hizo.
Hey, man, anybody else want to share what we can take away?
¿Alguien más quiere compartir lo que aprendimos?
Yes.
¿En nuestro hermano allá atrás?
Amen. Thank you, sir. Can we give him, make him feel welcome,
please? Vamos a dar un aplauso, que se sienta bienvenido. Amen.
Gracias, gracias. Yo fui muy, muy bendecido nomás el recordarme.
I was very blessed and to remember.
Lo que debo hacer.
What I should do.
Independientemente de las circunstancias.
No matter what the circumstances.
Y cómo me sienta.
And how I feel.
Cuál es mi problema.
What my problems may be.
Mis cargas.
My burdens.
Adorarle y alabarle con todo mi corazón.
Is to worship him and praise him with all of my heart.
Independientemente de cuáles son los síntomas y circunstancias.
No matter what the symptoms, the circumstances.
Un pequeñito, pequeñito testimonio.
A small testimony here.
En la tarde antes de venir.
The afternoon before we came.
Aquí estaba platicando con mis hijos.
I was dealing with my children.
Y el más chiquito me hizo una pregunta sobre las bendiciones de Dios.
And the smallest one asked me about the blessings of God.
Y me acuerdo que le dije, mira, vienen muchas formas y mami le dio un ejemplo y el primer y único ejemplo que se me vino, le digo, ¿sabías tú? Le digo, que... ¿Sabías tú? Le digo, que Dios, aún en alabanza, en cantarle, en un canto, Él te puede bendecir y darte lo que necesita, le digo.
And when he asked me about the blessings of God, I started thinking about so many different things that I can tell him. And the one thing that came to my mind was that, well, you know, son, even in the songs and the praises, you just want to sing it with all your heart.
Eso nomás me dio la confirmación de lo que estábamos hablando en la tarde, ¿verdad?
And I, by telling him that,
y agradezco a Dios por ello.
Of what we were speaking this afternoon, and I give thanks to that, to the Lord for that.
Gracias.
Thank you.
Amen.
Y gracias por el improvisado trabajo, ¿verdad? Que hicieron. Lo
and thank you for the improvising. We really appreciate it.
Gracias.
Thank you.
Amen. Thank you. I want to thank the musicians too, because thank you for that improvising. You guys are awesome.
A los músicos por improvisar también.
It's not easy to do something on the spot.
No es fácil hacer algo así tan de repente.
Especially when Brother Bernie III is up here, nobody knows what's going on.
Especialmente cuando el hermano Bernabé el tercero está haciendo algo aquí, no se sabe qué es lo que se va a hacer.
But one thing that I do know for sure.
Algo que yo sé de seguro.
Is that I love the Lord Jesus Christ.
Es que amo al Señor Jesucristo.
And He loves me more.
Y él me ama aún más. Amen.
And I'm so grateful for what He's done.
Estoy muy agradecido por lo que ha hecho.
That I have to praise Him.
Que tengo que alabarle.
Because not because I want to.
No porque yo quiero.
Or I do want to, but I have to praise Him because we don't have any other option.
Sí quiero, pero no hay que hacerlo porque no tenemos otra opción.
That's our only way out.
Es la única salida.
Would you like to share something?
¿Quieres compartir algo, mija?
Please come up.
Vamos aquí a ella.
She's so cute. She lifted her hand. She's all, "Can I say something?"
Levantó su mano así despacito. Dijo, "¿Puedo decir algo?"
Yes, absolutely.
You only have to believe, so God will get you out of your bad jail.
Hay que solamente creer y Dios te va a sacar de tu prisión. Amen.
Amen.
Wow.
That's it. You have to believe. All you have to do is believe, lo and único, God can get you out of your jail.
Lo único que tiene que hacer es creer y Dios te saca de tu prisión.
That Amen. Says everything.
Eso lo dice todo.
I'm done.
Ya terminé con eso.
Let's just close our eyes.
Vamos a cerrar nuestros ojos.
Let's say this little prayer.
Hacer esta pequeña oración.
Lord gracious and heavenly Father.
Señor Padre celestial.
All we have to do is believe.
Lo único que tenemos que hacer es creer.
And you can take us out of our bad jail.
Y tú nos vas a sacar de nuestra prisión.
Those words spoken by our sister were perfect, Lord.
Esas palabras habladas por nuestra hermanita fueron perfectas.
We ask that short little improvised skit.
Pedimos que esa obra pequeña de improviso
can be more than just a skit, Lord.
Que pueda ser más que una pequeña obra, Señor.
That you can take those crumbs.
Que tú tomes esas migajitas.
And multiply it to feed us, Lord God.
Y las multipliques para alimentarnos, Señor.
So we can grab a hold of the revelation.
Para tomar la revelación.
Of the power of praise.
Del poder de la adoración.
I ask that you bless everybody tonight for their efforts for being here.
Te pedimos que bendigas a todos por el esfuerzo que hicieron de estar aquí.
In the precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
En el precioso nombre del Señor Jesucristo.
Amén.
Amén. Bendito sea el Señor, nuestro Señor Jesucristo. Amén. Just thinking about what he's done in your life. Just one thing. And then we can sing, when I think of the goodness of Jesus. Amén.
Oh, when I think of the goodness of Jesus. And all that he's done.
Thank you.
Jesucristo. Amén. En el principio el Espíritu de Dios se movía sobre las aguas. Así dice su palabra. Aguas tipifica gente. Aquí vemos gente. El Espíritu de Dios se quiere mover en usted en esta noche. Necesitamos dejarnos nomás guiados por el Espíritu Santo. Amén. ¿Cuántos se quieren dejar guiar por el Espíritu Santo en esta noche? Nosotros, Dios nos ha dado el poder a nosotros. Si Él es el mismo de ayer, de hoy y para siempre, Él puede hacer lo mismo en esta noche, hermanos. Créanlo. Believe it or not. Believe it.
En el principio el Espíritu de Dios se movía sobre las aguas. En el principio el Espíritu de Dios se movía sobre las aguas, pero ahora se está moviendo dentro de mi corazón. Pero ahora se está moviendo dentro de mi corazón.
Pero ahora, oh, pero ahora se está moviendo dentro de mi corazón. Pero ahora se está moviendo dentro de mi corazón.
Amen. God bless you. We hope you were blessed this evening. We're just going to be praying to be dismissed.
Vamos a orar para despedir.
And don't forget about our next service.
No se les olvide nuestro siguiente servicio.
On Wednesday.
El miércoles.
And then Friday.
Y luego el viernes.
And then Sunday.
Y el domingo también.
And also, if you're thinking of going to the English Bible study on Tuesday.
Y también si está pensando en ir al estudio de Biblia el martes por la noche.
It's Tuesday, right, Brother
Art? El martes.
Your dad is going to give us a Bible study Tuesday
night. El martes con hermano Armagaña.
7:30. Do you remember?
7:30. A las 7 y media.
On Tuesday, Bible
martes,
study.
Martes, estudio bíblico.
Amen. In English.
En inglés.
So amen. Just please bow your heads.
Si pueden inclinar sus rostros.
Amen. Heavenly Father.
Padre celestial.
Thank you so much, Lord, for this blessing, Lord.
Gracias por esta bendición, Señor.
For this reminder of the power of praise.
El recordatorio del poder de la alabanza.
We ask that you bless everybody who came, Lord God.
Te pedimos que bendigas a cada persona que vino.
Everyone that took part in the service, Lord Jesus.
Toda persona que tomó parte en el servicio.
And we ask that we can take this and share with people.
Te pedimos que tomemos esto y lo compartimos con la gente.
As a reminder.
Como un recordatorio.
That no matter what we're going through.
De que no importa lo que estemos pasando.
We can praise you.
Podemos alabarte.
And you will break the prison doors.
Y tú abrirás las puertas de la prisión.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
En nombre del Señor Jesucristo.
Dismiss us from this place.
Despídenos de este lugar.
But not from your presence, Lord.
Mas nunca de tu presencia, Señor.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Gracias, Señor Jesús.
Amen.
Amen. Una vez más vamos a cantar en el principio el Espíritu de Dios y así vamos a estar siendo despedidos, hermanos. Dios les bendiga, que pasen buenas noches. Dios nos ha dado el gozo de nuestra salvación, hermanos. No dejemos que el diablo nos lo quite, amén.
En el principio el Espíritu de Dios se movía sobre las aguas. El Espíritu de Dios se movía sobre las aguas, pero ahora se está moviendo dentro de mi corazón, pero ahora se está moviendo dentro de aguas, pero ahora
Jerusalén, qué bonita es, calles de oro, mar de cristal. Por esas calles yo voy a caminar, calles de oro, mar de cristal. Por esas calles yo voy a caminar, calles de oro, mar de cristal. Thank you.